can give you some of mine. That's how we operate. That's how I go down. And I want to say to the captain of the Nation of Islam in St. Louis, what was the benefit? Now you look bad. You ever heard of public relations? You make Minister Farrakhan look bad because you supposed to represent him. But I'm trying to do my best to control public relations for you. Because I have no malice. It was an incident. It happened. Let us learn from the incident. Because black folks, I don't know what it is about us, dark Europeans, not black, because black people, we have learned our lesson. But dark Europeans, calling themselves black, when we start hating another black man, woo, oh man, we really hate, I hate him, I hate her. Man, we hate. If we hated America and these racist Caucasians the way we hate ourselves, boy, we will really be progressing using that energy of hatred. We really hate black folks. Do you know that the greatest killers, the greatest murderers, the greatest troublemakers on the earth have been those who claim they are peaceful? Study the history of Christianity. Study the history of Islam. Study religion. It's bloody. Filled with hatred, rape, murder, everything that you can think of. Then they turn around. Once they kill you and you submit to them, how peaceful it is. We so full of peace. Peace, peace. First of all, there's no such thing as peace. What you call peace is controlled violence. I'll say it again. What you call peace is controlled violence. This human being have no idea and have never experienced peace at no time. In your fictional fantasy world you have, but in our reality, in all the history that we have, it's full of bloodshed, violence, rape, envy, jealousy, hatred of women, hatred of the poor, and blase, blase. These people, many Christians would hate you because you won't accept Jesus Christ. They hate your guts. Go to hell. They'll tell you that quick. Same thing in Islam. You better accept Allah. They fill with hatred and violence. They want to control the world. And I want to just skip back real quick to the incident. If brother had a problem with me, back almost a year ago, I insulted the minister. My telephone number is on the video. Brother Donald Muhammad had my telephone number. Since you are on YouTube, you can email my channel. And you can talk to me and say and ask me, get a more understanding of what I was trying to say. I don't insult Minister Farrakhan. I admire him. That's my big brother. If there was no Farrakhan, chances are, again, I couldn't be talking to you. Why would I insult him? Now, I can critique his decisions. I can critique the teachings, whatever he's talking about. But as far as he as a person, no. Or is it that you really fear my critique of the teaching and opinion? You can't handle the real truth. Is that the real insult? Because if you bring any of that to me, you brag about you have the supreme wisdom and all this kind of stuff, I'll destroy it piece by piece. It no longer means nothing in 2011. Because the people are not dependent on belief no more. They want actual facts. People are self-thinking. They are no longer zombies in the mind. You can get that off to some black folks, but more and more white folks and others around the earth who are not caught up in religion. And all religion is slave making. All religion make robots. All religion creates followers. And then those who are leaders, the followers blindly follow them. That was the problem. That's why this incident occurred. Because this blind follower thought I was insulting his leader. Because he's a follower, not a leader upon himself. And why are you so upset over some words? You tripping off a YouTube video. And why are you going to get so angry at me when white folks and all kinds of people talk about and really do insult Louis Farrakhan every day? But you know something? See, let me tell y'all something. I'm going to bring this video to conclusion. This mentality that this dark European Muslim has. Do you realize? Listen. This man came to me filled with rage and hatred. Why? To another black man. I can guarantee you he has never done that to no white fella, no racist white guy, or a woman, or nobody like that. But he'll come to another black man. You know why? I want to remind y'all of something that the black Muslims don't talk about. Your first slave master was an African. They was black. That's who enslaved you first. Your own people. They was the first slave master. Lock you up in pig pens. They, the large tribes, destroyed the little tribes, took the women, killed the men, or bartered them off, traded with the white man for the captives. Your first slave master was black. The white man came later on. In fact, the white man learned about slavery and how to enslave by watching black folks. That's who taught him. The only difference was the white man got good at it. That's what happened. Everything, if the black man is the original man, and we are the teachers of everybody else, we are the fathers of civilization, we're the first. We are the first murderer. You are the first liar. You are the first one to disrespect your women. They all learned it from you because you was first. It ain't always good being first. Malcolm X was killed by black men. You want to blame white folks for self-hatred when this self-hatred was demonstrated long before the coming of this pale fella. But see, when the pale fella came on the scene, since you want to be an idiot, he gonna show you exactly how it's done. Do you believe, excuse me, do you really believe that with the mentality that these groups like Nation of Islam and the New Black Panther Party and some of these others, do you believe if they had power, you think they'll love you? you. They could be worse than the white man. During the Sunday meeting, Ishmael Muhammad bragged about how great his teachings are. I would challenge Ishmael Muhammad, I challenge Farrakhan, I challenge all these guys. I debate you down to the nitty gritty. And I break all of you down. Because it's time to bring you out of darkness. You think that you're in the light and you're not. You just as dead as anybody else is. Except you dead with a bow tie. You're a dark European. Master Farah Muhammad used Islam to counter the Christianity. I want to say this to us. See, Elijah Muhammad taught, we are not robots. But when some of us don't behave like robots, the blind followers get upset. Brother Donald, always the blind follower. They sound like Mr. Farrakhan DVD tapes and records. If Louis Farrakhan don't say it, they don't have nothing else to add. Blind follower, robot. That is not what Elijah Muhammad wanted. Period. He said, I don't want no blind followers. I want no robots.